I'm Aung Pyae Phyo. I'm a research physician of the Shobulum Malaria Research Unit, and I'm also helping the Malaria Elimination Project. Now I would like to give a brief discussion about the use of the anti-malaria drug in the Malaria Elimination Project. When we are considering the use of the anti-malaria drug, we need to keep in mind the most important thing is the safety and the of the antimalaria drug and the efficacy of the antimalaria drug. And again, that antimalaria drug should prevent or stop the transmission of the malaria. And more importantly, that antimalaria shouldn't select or shouldn't promote the emergence of a drug resistance. So in the Malaria Elimination Project, We distribute the anti-malaria drug in two approaches. One approach is through the community-based malaria clinics, where they use the anti-malaria drug artemether-lumefantrine, which is the first line anti-malaria drug of the Myanmar, plus the primogen single dose as a comedocytosidal drug. And again, another part is the distribution of the anti-malaria drug for the targeted mass drug administration activity. So in that activity, we try to choose a different anti-malaria drug rather than the artemether-lumefantrine, just to avoid the added drug pressure into the population. So we choose the dihydroartemisinin and piperaquine, and again, together with the primogen single dose as a comedocytosidal drug. So in providing the mass drug administration, there will be two approaches. One approach is the indirect MDA or indirect mass drug administration in the past by adding the anti-malaria drug into the foodstuff, especially the salt. But this approach can lead to the introduction of the subtherapeutic drug level into the community for a long period of time, and it can be linked to the emergence of a chloroquine resistance in case of the chloroquine added salt distribution in the history. So another approach of the mass drug administration is the direct MDA or targeted mass drug treatment, where we provide the therapeutic dose of the anti-malaria drug in single or several rounds. Usually we do it with two or three rounds. And the use of the targeted mass drug administration could offer us more good supervision on the direct observation of treatment therapy and good compliance in the community. And again, we could monitor the adverse events of the drug in the community, and as well as the community awareness and the community participation as well. And again, why do we choose the artemisinin combination therapy for the mass drug administration? So we choose the artemisinin combination therapy because in the artemisinin combination therapy, there will be two components. One component is the artemisinin component. The artemisinin, which kills the drug very rapidly, which is the parasite reduction ratio of 10 to the power 4, power 1 asexual cycle, that is 48 hours, and that is so fast, and then the residual parasite will be mopped up by the partner drug. And again, these two drugs, artemisinin and the partner drug, they protect each other from the drug-resistant parasite to emerge. And again, the artemisinin drug, they just stay in the blood for very short. The half-life of just less than 1 hour, and giving less chance for the parasite to develop the resistance. So the use of the combination therapy, the artemisinin combination therapy, the dihydroartemisinin piperaquine with the primogene single dose as a comedocytosidal drug in the mass drug administration project, it could lead to the reduction in the parasite reservoir in the population, and then it could also protect the uninfected people from the new infection, and then it could also cut the transmission of the malaria from one person to another.